So welcome back, everyone. I think you guys had a nice break and tea. So we are gonna end like almost like, you know, like first day. So there is a one talk left over. So very interesting talk. Yeah. So we are introducing a local community here, like who are like using like this, telling the story of what they do. I hope people will settle down. Yeah, we'll get started with this. Yeah, so we are introducing Dinesh team here. Dinesh has a computer science background and is a founder of Janastu Bangalore. Janastu has been providing a free and open source solutions for NGOs and MPOs since 2002. So Dinesh is also a founding member of International Institute of Heart, Culture and Democracy. He and his team, Helavaru, is here to narrate the stories about the role of local communities in wayfinding and their contribution towards the evolving of maps. I welcome Dinesh and Helavaru team.
Hi, thanks, Chetan. So I would like to welcome each of my team here. It's mostly their work, and I have stepped in to do some interpreting. So I'll call Kadirappa first. Bani Kadirappa. So Kadirappa is a Helavaru. Helavaru. How many knows Kannada? Yeah. Helavaru. Oh, is it Bangalore? So Helavaru means tellers, right? So these are the people who tell your story. What is your story? It depends on where you came from, who your ancestors are, how you have moved through a land, what is your land boundary, what is your community land boundary, right? And they say it in a way that the people who they talk about get it, right? There is no like semantic distance. I am going to type this. If you understand, right? No, the stories are made, tuned to their community, right? So we'll get to know about it. Sir, Hanumathappa Varpani. Hanumathappa is a very senior Helavaru. This is a great opportunity. We've been looking for them. We see them often when we are traveling, but they don't move from their places. Once we asked them if they can come to Bangalore, they said, I'll have to come with my whole caravan, my set of bullocks, the families, the, you know, small group. Only then I have to leave 2 months before if I have to come to Bangalore, right? And still, you know, it's not their way to come to Bangalore. So that will never happen. And then we found this group, which is near Chitradurga Challakere, who have become more sthaliya, right? They have decided to stay in one spot and their roles are changing. Mostly they're becoming farmers. So you are all lucky they are here because it didn't rain. If it had rained, they would have said, sorry, we have better things to do. So it's my pleasure that they are here, and I'm very happy to present them. In all this, Nagraj, Mani. Nagraj is the faculty of sociology at HPC College in Challakere. He is a sociology person who... Sir, I'll quote you. Who has, luckily for us, he's from the same village where these people are. So he knows them. That's our opportunity again. Because they wouldn't come by themselves. Even if I go, they'll, you know. So he has been able to talk to them for a few days, prepare them, and they're able to be here. And he has a very interesting personal story on how his conflict, Helavaru came in as a conflict for conflict resolution in his family land problem. It's a very, very interesting thing going on here. And Gopi, please come. Gopi is what we call as Helavaru of the Eluvas. He is going to explain, to tell us stories about the Eluvas, right? So it's an ongoing joke here. Well, you know, he goes and asks them, who's your Eluva, right? Who's telling your stories? And then he said, they'll say, like, maybe you have to do it. So and other than that, we have Banu and Sanket are also here. So we would just jump in whenever, yeah. And our role is to just help interpret, because we've been talking to them for so long now, right? So what we do is I will put a few slides and try to explain what's going on here. And then they will do a narration, their way of telling, right? We'll come to that. And then I will open up for you. One will be in Telugu, one will be in Kannada. I'll open up for you to help understand what happened, right? So that is where most of you will have to talk, right? So, you know, this is the OSM here. Let's help other people understand by helping yourself understand, okay? And then Gopi will hop in and he will talk about the structural aspects of how Helavas are actually a blockchain, why there is trust in the communities, right? So all through, one of the things I want to do is for you to connect what the future is. Now that we are here in the internet, where can we go by reflecting on what is possible, right? So that's my effort here. Shall I speak here? Or?
It's your wish.
Yeah, I'll speak here. Okay.
Can you help with the slides?
No. Yeah, maybe. I'll call you when I want
okay,
to. Thanks. So this title was given by the committee, so I am happy with it. So wayfinding is quite personal, and therefore it's a nice thing than anything else. But the idea of what storytelling can deliver is quite amazing, right? So, and there are, there are lots of nomadic communities in India, right? And was, right? To the extent that if you talk to the nomadic party of Karnataka, they'll claim that more than 60% of Karnataka is nomadic. So if they do a party, political party, you know, it would be, you know, that's their strength, you know, if they can gather it, right? So that's the thing, right? But we don't know about it. We see them on the, when we are traveling, we see them, maybe we don't see them, right? This is your opportunity to maybe see them, right? Our first thing is to see them, right? So, okay. So what are the nomadic communities? Pastoral communities, right? So we've been working with Gopi for more than 10 years on pastoralists, following them, trying to understand what they do, what the resources are, and seeing how a little bit of activism can get them nomadic rights, right? Because they walk through common property reserves, right? Grasslands, right? And there are storytellers, there are traders, there are makers, there are people who come home and make stuff for you, right? And entertainers, healers, magicians, right? And each one has a very good role, right? It could be a magician, but he could be an epidemiologist. You have to think like that here. You have to start seeing things, right? What's going on underneath these stories, right? That's the crux. So for example, right? How many people think it's wasteland? Look at the land there, right? When you have food, if it's a food security issue, is this land now being extremely useful? Right? This is the undercurrent that you have to look through in the whole thing, right? And here is a Patichitragar from West Bengal. he comes home with a song and a scroll to your door and gives you a piece of news. Before the TV, he would unfurl the scroll and walk through and make a song for your community and sing. Right? That's the power. So the most important thing is, now you say, in-home entertainment. Right? So they always came home, right? And it was entertainment, it was news, it was information, it was community mapping, it was recording of the genealogy, it was, you know, this thing that went together. Not just one of them, right? There are many, many, many of them. And what we need to understand at the same time is, in this world of Facebook and Twitter and Google, just the cultural economy used to be over 30% of the whole economy, right? Now they're all striving for that, but imagine there was a world where this was the way culture provided economical benefits. And one thing that you can kind of see through here is, if I can make that point, that there was an internet before internet. Right? There was this information network, right? Slow, steady, delivering to the point, taking a piece of information nugget from here and updating over there to updating over there, all in a way that people appreciated what was going on. Only then there would be this trust, there would be the corrections, there would be the updating of the records and all that. And they would be invited back. Right? So Gopi named this whole process sacred geographers. Right? So now you will witness some of that, why they're sacred geographers, because of the respect they get. Right? They are so crucial to your community, to your property, to your finding relationships. Right? They go from introducing you to a girl to, you know, finding the local records. So briefly, you know, this is not to say anything about the current state of the map, but ideally, right? So maps are denotational, but storytelling is connotational. Right? It's not about knowing. So you go to France. What do you do? Oh, I want to see Eiffel Tower. No, all you have to do is walk the street. Eiffel Tower will show itself. Right? It's the connotation, the story, the people, the being. Right, so that's the difference, right? So we'll go through this Gudikattu tradition and this, how it's important, how it delineates different communities and keeps them alive. And it's all what they call as singing traditions, right? There is a way of singing, the way of praising, there's a way of giving a data point, there's a way of updating. Everything is like when you see your TV and suddenly the ad comes on, right? You know, like news comes on. So all this is structured in there. Can you help me play? Just play this thing.
ಹೆಳವಾ ಬಂದೇವ್ರಿ ಬಾಗಿಲ ಮುಂದ ಹೆಂಡರ್ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಕರಕೊಂಡ ಬಂಡಿಯ ಹೂಡಿಕೊಂಡ ಬಂದ ಇಳದೇವ್ರಿ ಊರ ಮುಂದ ಬಂದ ಇಳದೇವ್ರಿ ಊರ ಮುಂದ ಮಲಿಗ್ವಾಡ ಊರ ಚಂದ ಸಾವುಕಾರ ಮಣಿ ಚಂದ ಹೆಳವಾ ಬಂದೇವ್ರಿ ಬಾಗಿಲ ಮುಂದ ಹೆಳವಾ ಬಂದೇವ್ರಿ ಬಾಗಿಲ ಮುಂದ ಹೆಂಡರ್ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಕರಕೊಂಡ ಬಂಡಿಯ ಹೂಡಿಕೊಂಡ ಬಂದ ಇಳದೇವ್ರಿ ಊರ ಮುಂದ ಬಂದ ಇಳದೇವ್ರಿ ಊರ ಮುಂದ ಕಲಗಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ತಾಲೂಕಿನ್ಯಾಗು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕಳ್ಬಳಿ ಬಾಳ ಐತೆವ್ವ ಊರಿಗೆ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಮಣದಾನ ಕಳ್ಳಾಗಿನ ಕತ್ರಿ ಅಂತ ಸಕ್ಕರೆಯಾಗಿನ ಚೂರಿ ಅಂತ ಸ್ವಸ್ಥ್ಯಾರ ಕೂಡಿ ಮಣ್ಣಿ ಹೊಡೆದಾಡಿ ಕಟ್ಟರದ ಕಬ್ಬಿನ ಹೊರಿ ಹೆಂಗ ಎಲ್ಲಾರು ಬ್ಯಾರೆ ಆಗಿ ಕಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ ಜನ ಕಟ್ಟಿ ಮ್ಯಾಗ ಬ್ಯಾರಿಟ್ಟಾರಿವ ತಟ್ಟಿ ಕಟ್ಟಿ ಪಾಪ ಅದ ಹತ್ಕೊಂತ ಕರ್ಕೊಂತ ತಾನ ಅಡ್ಗಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಉಣ್ಣದ್ ನೋಡಿ ನನಗೂ ದುಃಖ ಬಂತ ನಡ್ತಾಯವ್ವ ಬಿಜಾಪುರ ಜಿಲ್ಲಾದಾಗು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕಳ್ಬಳಿ ಬಾಳ ಐತೆವ್ವ ಜಿಲ್ಲಾಕ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಮಣತಾನ ದ್ರಾಕ್ಷಿ ತ್ವಾಟ ದಾಳಂಬ್ರಿ ಗಿಡ ದಾದ್ ನಹಿ ಪಿರಾದ ನಹಿ ಅಂತ ಮನ್ಯಾಗ ಹೀರೋ ಹೊಂಡ ಮಾರುತಿ ಕಾರು ಬಾಗಲ್ ಮುಂದ ಮುದೋಳ್ ನಾಯಿ ಸಾಕ್ಯಾರಣ ತಾಯವ್ವ ಮನ್ನೆ ಮನಿಗೆ ಹೋಗಬಾರ್ದು ಹೋಗಿ
what do I do? So this is a song about somebody singing about them, right? How they come, how they update data, how they, right? I won't have time to go through this, but this is this for you to see how it goes, right? So what I'll do is so there are two kinds of helavas that we have come across, and that's what they say. One is yattina helava. Yattina helava is what you saw in those pictures. People with bullock carts go as a caravan. Yattu means bullock, right? So, and what they do, they go like they come to Arun's house and talk about, you know, why his grandfather went to overseas, right? And what was the need and what's the greatness about it? Arun was continuously feel like, oh my God, I'm in such a great family. Right? Continuously, right? And they keep coming around. And now Arun has a baby. So they will record it. And they'll go in, sister, where's your sister? So to her place and then update. Right? This is the information that was, right? So, and then Arun will be so happy. His sister will be so happy. They get something in return. And then there is Ganta Helavas, right? So these people are the Ganta Helavas. So they have a bell, and they have been accepted by the community to do their duties, right? So they record, their main thing is the narrative of their community, their so-called, you might call it mythologically, but the grounding of where the community, why are we part of this community? Why is it so nice to be part of this caste, this community, right? So, and these days, they have updated themselves. They keep minute details of their records. You go to their camp, children are trained to update because the book's there, right? And the information overflows the page. So you need to keep on updating, right? So it's a school that goes on, and they keep on going to the same people, same family. So now we talk about something called gudikattu. Gudikattu is every one of these Ganta Helavas have a gudi. Gudi is a deity, right? Based on their deity, they will have like some kind of a record, and they will be accepted to tell the story of their community, right? So you will see like these are the number of different gudis of the gudikattu in the Chalakere area that Professor Nagaraj has labeled. And how many of you know Amrut Mal Kaval? It was in the news quite a lot. And so around Amrut Mal Kaval, which is a huge grasslands area near Chellakere, there are about four communities, right? Myasa Beada, Kadu Galla, Uru Galla, Upara. Right? Kadu means forest, and Uru means town, right? And they used to be around, and they spoke about the tracts of land, what is the significance, what is the thing, right? Now, of course, it's been taken over by lots of scientific institutes called for development, for nuclear research. But what is important is to understand, later Gopi will tell you more, the architecture of why they trust, what happens in that, right? So these are some of the roles that they play. There's a priest who will do a ritual part. There'll be a yajaman who does the administrative aspects, and there'll be the gudi gauda, which is like the local head, and there's one who takes care, like talks about animals, right? And talavar, the T is missing. Talavar is a messenger. Oh, T is there. Yeah. So talavar is a messenger, right? He comes announcing. And helavas, these are the people who does documents, right? Maintain documents. Notes down, somebody dies, informs other people. They go by foot, there's a very good reason. So I'll leave it here, and I'll give it to Nagaraj now to talk about his personal story of what happened, and I'll try to briefly say it in English after that. Okay.
You'll get a break.
Check.
ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಮಧ್ಯಾಹ್ನದ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರಗಳು. ನನ್ನ ಹೆಸರು ನಾಗರಾಜ್ ಅಂತೇಳಿ. ನಾನು ಸರ್ಕಾರಿ ಪ್ರಥಮ ದರ್ಜೆ ಕಾಲೇಜು ಚಳ್ಳಕೆರೆನಲ್ಲಿ ಸಮಾಜಶಾಸ್ತ್ರದ ಸಹಾಯಕ ಪ್ರಾಧ್ಯಾಪಕನಾಗಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ನಾನು ಈ ಎಳವ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಟೀಸ್ನವರು ಏನಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಇವರು ನನ್ನ ಊರಿನವರು. ನನ್ನ ಊರು ಚಿತ್ರದುರ್ಗ ಜಿಲ್ಲೆ ಚಳ್ಳಕೆರೆ ತಾಲೂಕು ಗೋಪನಹಳ್ಳಿ ಅಂತೇಳಿ. ಇವರ ಮಹತ್ವ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಬಹುಶಃ ಇವತ್ತಿನ ಆಧುನಿಕ ಜಗತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಳಷ್ಟು ಜನಕ್ಕೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಆದರೆ ಅದರ ಮಹತ್ವ ಭಾಳಷ್ಟು ಇದೆ ಅಂತೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೇಳೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನನ್ನದೇ ಆಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಂದು ವೈಯಕ್ತಿಕವಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಂದು ಕಥೆಯನ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ. ಅದರ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಅವರ ಪ್ರಾಮುಖ್ಯತೆ ಮತ್ತು ಅವರ ಬುದ್ಧಿವಂತಿಕೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ನಮಗೆ ಭಾಳಷ್ಟು ರಾಮಾಯಣ ಮತ್ತು ಮಹಾಭಾರತ ಅಥವಾ ಪುರಾಣದ ಕಥೆಗಳು, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿಗಳು ಯಾರು ಅಥವಾ
I just wanted to translate for those who do not know Kannada. He just introduced himself. His name is Professor Nagaraj, Professor of Sociology. And he is very proud that today he has been able to get the Helavas over here. And he definitely notices their importance in the social systems. And he wants to tell his personal story, that how he was able to resolve something within his family with the help of the Helavas of his family. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್
ಬಹುಶಃ ಈಗ ನಮಗೆ ರಾಮಾಯಣ ಮತ್ತು ಮಹಾಭಾರತ ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಮಹತ್ತರವಾದ ಕಾವ್ಯಗಳಿದ್ದಾವೆ. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ರಾಮ ಯಾರು, ರಾಮನ ತಂದೆ ಯಾರು, ಅಥವಾ ಮಹಾಭಾರತ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಅರ್ಜುನ ಯಾರು, ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ಪರಮಾತ್ಮ ಯಾರು, ಇದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಆದರೆ ನಮಗೆ ನಮ್ಮದೇ ಆಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ನಮ್ಮ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿ ಅಥವಾ ನಮ್ಮ ದೊಡ್ಡಪ್ಪ ಚಿಕ್ಕಪ್ಪ ಇವರದಿಷ್ಟೇ ನಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತು. ಅದರ ಮುಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಥವಾ ಅದರ ಹಿಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿಬಿಟ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮುತ್ತಾತ ಯಾರು ಅಥವಾ ಅವರ ಅಪ್ಪ ಯಾರು, ಹೀಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ವಂಶಾವಳಿ ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಬೇಕಾದರೆ ನಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋದಿಲ್ಲ.
ಸೊ ಇಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಹಿಸ್ಟಾರಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮಿಥಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್, ಮೈಥೊಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ವೆಲ್ ಫೆಮಿಲಿಯರ್ ಟು ಅಸ್, ಲೈಕ್ ರಾಮ, ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಟುಡೇ ಹೂ ಅವರ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ರೈಟರ್ಸ್. ಬಟ್ ಅವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ವಿ ವುಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಆರ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಟು ಅವರ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಆರ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಆರ್ ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್. ಬಟ್ we wouldn't be knowing the entire history of our genealogy. And this documentation is what Helavas used to take care.
ಒಂದು 50 ವರ್ಷದ ಕೆಳಗೆ ನನಗೆ ವೈಯಕ್ತಿಕವಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಂದು ಒಂದು ಅನುಭವ ಆಯಿತು. ಅದೇನು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನಿರುವಾಗ ನಮ್ಮ ಊರು ಆಗಲೇ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೇನೆ ಚಳ್ಳಕೆರೆ ಹತ್ತಿರ ಗೋಪನಹಳ್ಳಿ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಜ್ಜಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು ನನಗೆ. ಇಲ್ಲ, ನನ್ನ ಊರು ಜಮ್ಮಾಪುರ ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು. ಮತ್ತು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಕೇಳಿದ್ವಿ, ನೀವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾಕೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದೀಯಾ ಅಂತೇಳಿ. ಇಲ್ಲ, ನನಗೆ ಜಮ್ಮಾಪುರಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿತ್ತು ಮದುವೆ ಮಾಡಿ, ಆದರೆ ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮನಿಗೆ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ವಯಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ತೀರು ಹೋಗಿದ್ದರಿಂದ ನಿಮ್ಮ ತಾತ ಮತ್ತು ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮ ಇವನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ನಾನು ಈ ಕಡೆ ಬಂದೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ನನಗೆ ಒಂದು 50 ವರ್ಷದ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಹೇಳಿದ ನೆನಪುಂಟು.
ಸೊ 50 years ago, ವೆನ್ ನಾಗರಾಜ್ ವಾಸ್ ಯಂಗ್, his grandmother used to tell him a story that they are from a place called Jambapura, that's somewhere near Bijapur, Chitradurga. Currently he stays in Chelkare. And then he would curiously ask his grandmother, then why are we in Gopnali in Chelkare? And she would say that she was married to a person in Jambapura, but they had to migrate for personal reasons.
ಸರಿ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಜಮೀನ್ದಾರು, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಬ್ಬ ಯಜಮಾನ ಇದ್ದ, ಪದೇ ಪದೇ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಗೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ಆಗಿಂದಾಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಜ್ಜಿಯವರಿಗೆ ಬಂದು ಮಾತಾಡಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾಯಿದ್ರು. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನಮಗೆ ಇವರು ಹಳೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಿಕರು ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅವರು ತಿಳಿಸ್ತಾಯಿದ್ರು. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನಮಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಸಂಬಂಧಿಕರು ಇವರು ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅಷ್ಟು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವಿ. ಅದರ ಮುಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇನ್ನು ನಮಗೇನು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಸರ್, ಈ ರೀತಿ ಇರುವಾಗ ಕೊನೆಗೆ ನನ್ನ ಹೆಂಡತಿಯ ತಮ್ಮನಿಗೆ ಮದುವೆ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಾವು ಹೊರಟಾಗ ಅದೇ ಜಮ್ಮಾಪುರಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋದ್ವಿ. ಹೋಗಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಹೆಣ್ಣನ್ನ ಗುರುತು ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ, ಮದುವೆನೂ ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ. ಆ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಜ್ಜಿ ಊರು ಇದು ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು ನಮಗೆ ನೆನಪು ಬಂದು, ಆಗ ಆ ಊರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದೆ ನಮ್ಮದು ಕೂಡ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೇ ಊರು, ಆದರೆ ನಾವೀಗ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಗೋಪನಹಳ್ಳಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆಟ್ಲ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೇವೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರ ಮನೆ ಏನು ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ನನಗೇನು ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಊರಿನವರಿಗೆ ಆ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದೆ.
So they were jamindars in Jambapura and they had lands and everything, but they had left all of those things and migrated to their current location in Chelkere. Our years passed, and now recently his brother-in-law was about to get married, and to search for a bride, they went back to this place, Jambapura. And to the bride's family, when they had to introduce themselves and tell about themselves, he did say that we are from here, but we don't know anything anymore. And all these things happened, and his marriage happened.
Sare, kalada varsha, ಆ ಊರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಜಾತ್ರೆ ಆಯಿತು. ಜಾತ್ರೆಗೆ ನನ್ನನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಕರೆದಿದ್ದರು. ಆ ಜಾತ್ರೆಗೆ ನಾನು ಹೋದಾಗ ಆ ಜಾತ್ರೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇಬ್ಬರು ಎಳವರು ಬಂದಿದ್ದರು. ಅವರು ಎಲ್ಲಿದ್ದ ಬಿಜಾಪುರದಿಂದ ಬಂದಿದ್ದರು. ಆ ಬಿಜಾಪುರದಿಂದ ಈ ಥರ ಎಳವರು ಬಂದಾಗ ಅವರ ಮನೆತನದ ಇತಿಹಾಸವನ್ನು ಹೇಳುವಾಗ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪೂರ್ವಿಕರು ಇಬ್ಬರು, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಓಬಳೇಶಪ್ಪ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬರು ಲಕ್ಕಪ್ಪ ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇವರಿಬ್ಬರು ಆಂಧ್ರ ಪ್ರದೇಶದಿಂದ ಆನೆಗುಂದಿಗೆ ಬಂದುಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆನೆಗುಂದಿಯಿಂದ ಜಂಬಾಪುರಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದು ಜಂಬಾಪುರದಲ್ಲಿ ಓಬಳೇಶಪ್ಪ ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಒಬ್ಬರು ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಉಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರು. ಲಕ್ಕಪ್ಪ ಅನ್ನೋರು ಚಳ್ಳಕೆರೆ ತಾಲೂಕು ಗೋಪನಹಳ್ಳಿಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಸೆಟ್ಲ್ ಆದರು ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಿದರು.
ಸೊ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ವೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಫೆಸ್ಟಿವಲ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲೇಜ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಹೆಳವಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಹೂ ವರ್ ಸಿಂಗಿಂಗ್ about the genealogies of all the castes that subscribe to that particular temple. And apparently, because he was from Jambapura, he was curious enough to know and go and ask them if they know anything about his family. And when he asked, they did have the records, and he found out that they were originally a migrants from Andhra Pradesh, and his four great-grandfathers, Oblesappa and Kalappa, one of them settled near Hampi in Anegundi, and the other one moved to Chalkere.
Aga takshana nanage gotayitu namma ejje helida nenapu namadu Jambapura naavu illige bande settle agidvi namma taata nesaru Lakkappa ant helibitt helidrala ade Lakkappa namma taata avara maga Kariyappa Kariyappana maga matte Ningappa ant helibittu hige naalku tele marnavaru idare avanu Lakkappa ant helibittu ashte helide ashte alla aa Lakkappanige matte gandu makkalilla ನಾಲ್ಕು ಜನ ಹೆಣ್ಣು ಮಕ್ಕಳು. ಆ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಜನ ಹೆಣ್ಣು ಮಕ್ಕಳಲ್ಲಿ ಒಬ್ಬರಿಗೆ ಚಿತ್ರದುರ್ಗಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬರಿಗೆ ಹಿರಿಯೂರು ತಾಲೂಕಿಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಹಾಗೆ ಇನ್ನು ಇಬ್ಬರನ್ನು ಅದೇ ಊರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಗೋಪನಹಳ್ಳಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಯಾರಿಗೆ? ನನ್ನ ಅಪ್ಪ ಮತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ದೊಡ್ಡಪ್ಪನಿಗೆ, ಅಕ್ಕ ತಂಗಿಯರಿಗೆ ಇಬ್ಬರಿಗೂ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಮದುವೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ.
ಸೊ ಫಾದರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಸೊ ಈ ಟೆಲ್ಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಆಫ್ ಫೋರ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಹೌ ಇಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಆ್ಯಡ್ ನೋ ಸನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫೋರ್ ಡಾಟರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ those four daughters were given in marriage across locations via Chitradurga, and two sisters were married in Gopnalli. One is his mother and other is aunt.
Iga aa helavaru helida record nida namage nane ant helibittu gotayitu. Jothege adikkinta adbhuta enu ant helidre naavenu madhe maadkondu bandiddeve nana aliyenige ಅದೇ ಮನೆಯವರು, ನಮ್ಮ ಸಂತತಿಯವರು ಮತ್ತು ನಾವು ಅವರು ಅಣ್ಣ ತಮ್ಮಂದಿರು ಒಂದೇ ಕುಲದವರು ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅಥವಾ ಒಂದೇ ವಂಶಸ್ಥರು ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯಿತು. ಆಗ ನನಗೆ ಹಿಂದಿನದೆಲ್ಲ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ಆಯಿತು. ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಬ್ಬರೆಲ್ಲ ನೀವು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಜಮೀನ್ದಾರು, ನಿಮಗೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜಮೀನಿದೆ, ನೀವು ಬಂದರೆ ಜಮೀನನ್ನು ಕೊಡಿಸ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೇಳ್ತಾಯಿದ್ರು. ಬಟ್ ನಾವು ಇಲ್ಲೇ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಜಮೀನ್ದಾರಾಗಿದ್ವಿ, ಆಗಾಗಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಅಗತ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಸದ್ಯ ಇಷ್ಟಾದ ನಮ್ಮ ವಂಶಾವಳಿ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅಂತೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಖುಷಿ ಆಯಿತು.
The final bit was that then they found out also that the bride they got married for his brother-in-law are also related to their own clan, and he was also able to figure out from this that they also have lands in this place, and they were also saying that you should be owning them as your right, but he just gave up on all those things.
Koneyadagi inta ondu satyamshavana nanage helikottiddu ee elavaru elavaru mukantara nanage gotagide agagi ivattu kuda nana avarana ತುಂಬಾ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳಿಂದ ನಾನು ನೆನಪಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ತೇನೆ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು
ಫಾರ್ ರಿವೀಲಿಂಗ್ ದ ಟ್ರೂತ್. ಇ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಎಳವಾಸ್ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಟೀಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಸ್ ಪರ್ಸ್ನಲ್.
ಶಿವ ಶಿವನು ನಮಸ್ತುವ ದುವತ್ತೋ ಶಿವನು ಕೊಂಡಾಡುವ ದೂರಿಯಾಳುವತ್ತ ವಿಷ್ಣನ ಮಡದಿ ಶ್ರೀಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿಯಮ್ಮ ಈಶ್ವರನ ಮಡದಿ ಪಾರ್ವತಿ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ ಮಡದಿ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ವಿಷ್ಣು ಈಶ್ವರ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ತ್ರಿಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳು ನಂದು ಮ್ಯಾಲೆ ಗೌಡ ವಿಷ್ಣುವೀಶ್ವರ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ತ್ರಿಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳು ನಂದು ಮ್ಯಾಲೆ ಗೌಡ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕುಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಹುಟ್ಟಿ ಕುಲುವು ಕೊಂಡಾಡುವುದು ಹೊತ್ತು ಗೋತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಹುಟ್ಟಿ ಗೋತ್ರ ಕೊಂಡಾಡುವುದು ಉದಿಯಾಳುವತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ಮಪ್ಪ ಮಾರುದ್ದವತ್ತೆ ಹುಟ್ಟಿದವನು ಮಾರ್ಗಾನಿ ಗೌಡ ಮಾರುದ್ದವತ್ತೆ ಹುಟ್ಟಿದವನು ಮಾರ್ಗಾನಿ ಗೌಡ ಮಾರ್ನು ಕುಲಗಳೆಂದು ಕೊಂಡಾಡಿಸಿಕೊಂಡಂತ ಏಳಟ್ಟಿ ಗೌಡ್ರು ಮೊಮ್ಮಗನೇ ಮಾರ್ನು ಕುಲಗಳೆಂದು ಕೊಂಡಾಡಿಸಿಕೊಂಡಂತ ಏಳಟ್ಟಿ ಗೌಡ್ರು ಮೊಮ್ಮಗನೇ ಹಂಚಿನ ದಟ್ಟಿಯಪ್ಪ ಕಂಚಿನ ಕಡಗವಲ್ಲ ನಾರುಗಲ್ಲು ಸಿಪ್ಪು ಗೊಡ್ಲೆ ಬಿರದಾಂಕಿಗಳು ಪಡೆದಂತ ನಮ್ಮಪ್ಪಗಳು ಬಿಳೆ ಮೀಶ ಕರಡೇನು ರಾಯ ಬಿಳೆ ಮೀಶ ಕರಡೇನು ರಾಯ ಸೂರ್ಯವಂಶಕ್ಕೆ ಹುಟ್ಟಿದಂತ ಸಿತ್ತುಮುತ್ತಿ ನಮ್ಮಪ್ಪ ಕರಡೇನು ಗೌಡ್ರು ಇವರು ನನ್ನ ತಂದೆ ಬಾಲಮ್ಮನ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಏಳು ಮಂದಿ ಗೌಡ್ರು ನಾಗಮ್ಮನ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಏಳು ಮಂದಿ ಗೌಡ್ರು ಕರೋ ಬಜ್ಜಿ ದಂಡಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರವಾಗಿ ಕರೋ ಬೆನಳ್ಳಿ ಹತ್ರ ದಂಡಕ್ಕೆ ಹೊರಗಾಗಿ ಬಂದಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥವ್ರು ಇವರು ನಾಗಮ್ಮನ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಇವರೇ ಮಾರ್ಗೊಲ್ರು ಕಳ್ದೇನು ಗೌಡ್ರು ಬಾಲಮ್ಮನ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಏಳು ಮಂದಿ ಗೌಡ್ರು ಕರೋ ಬೆನಳ್ಳಿ ಕರೋ ಬಜ್ಜಿ ದಂಡಕ್ಕೆ ಒಳಗಾಗಿ ಏಳು ಸಂಸಾರದು ಆಗ್ತಾಳಿಗಳು ಕಿತ್ತು ಸಿಂತಾಳಿಗೆ ಹಾಕಿದಂತ ಗೌಡ್ರು ಕಣಪ್ಪ ಸಿತ್ತು ಗೊಲ್ರು ಅಲ್ಲೇರಿಂದ ಇವರು ದಂಡಕ್ಕೆ ಹೊರಗಾಗಿ ಕರುಬೆನಳ್ಳಿ ಬಾಲೆನಳ್ಳಿ ಕಟ್ಟೆ ಮನೆಗಳು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಅಲ್ಲೇಲಿಂದ ಬಂದು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಆಂಧ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾಲೆನಳ್ಳಿ ಶಿವ ಚಿತ್ರಲಿಂಗನ ಗುಡಿ ಗೋಪುರಗಳು ನಿರ್ಣಯ ಮಾಡಿದಂತ ಗೌಡ್ರು ಮೊಮ್ಮಗನೇ ಪಾಲೇನಳ್ಳಿ ಶಿವ ಶತ್ರುಲಿಂಗ ಜಂಪಾಲು ಗೊಡಗಿನವನು ಜಂಗಳು ಗುದಿರವನು ಬೋಧಿ ಮುಚ್ಚಿದ ಚಂಡ ಭೂತಳರು ಉದ್ದಂಡ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಲೋಕಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಚಂಡ ಪಾಲೇನಳ್ಳಿ ಒಳಗೆ ನೆಲಗೊಂಡಂತ ಮಾಗುರುವ ಶಿವ ಶತ್ರುಲಿಂಗನು ಪಾದಗಳು ನಮ್ಮ ಗೌಡ್ರು ಮನೆ ಮುಂದೆ ಕೊಂಡಾಡುವುದು ಉರಿಯಾಳುವತ್ತೆ ಶಿವ ಶತ್ರುಲಿಂಗನ ಪಾದಗಳು ನೆಂದು ಮೇಲೆ ಗೌಡ್ರೆ ಅವರು ಬಾಲಮ್ಮನ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಏಳು ಮಂದಿ ಗೌಡ್ರು ನಾಗಮ್ಮನ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಏಳು ಮಂದಿ ಗೌಡ್ರು ಕಿತ್ತಾಟ ಹಿಡಿದು ಬಿಟ್ರು ಕಿತ್ತಾಟ ಹಿಡಿದು ಆವಾಗ ನಮ್ಮಪ್ಪಗಳು ಹರಿಮರ ತರಿಮರಗಳು ಕಡಿದು ಪಾಲೇನಳ್ಳಿ ತಾಜರಿ ಮರ ತರಿಮರ ಕಡಿದು ಅವ್ರಂದ್ರದಡಕ್ಕೆ ಇವರು ಹೋಗಲ್ಲ ಇವ್ರದಂದ್ರಡಕ್ಕೆ ಅವರು ಬರೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಇವರು ದಂಡಕ್ಕೆ ಹೊರಗಾಗಿ ಪಾಲೇನಳ್ಳಿ ಶಿವ ಶತ್ರುಲಿಂಗನ್ನ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಗೌಡ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲೇಲಿಂದ ಎಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಗ್ವಾಪ್ನಳ್ಳಿ ಮಳ್ಳು ದಿಬ್ಬಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದು ಏಳಟ್ಟುಗಳು ಇಟ್ಟುಕೊಂಡು ಧರಂಗುರಿಯಾಗಿ ಬಾಳೋ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲೇ ದಾಣಿ ಕೆರೆ ಒಳಗೆ ಕೆರೆ ಒಳಗೆ
ರಿಯಲಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಪಾಲಜೈಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹೀ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ 3 days. Right? And he would love to tell the whole thing, right? So those of you who are all interested will get him over for a couple of days and and do another mapping party. So But it was so funny, for those of you who understand. We'll come back to that.
Montari Chisto Yemanta Melu Gorodu Konda Purma Bobli Narishima Idu Kallu Shiru Sitturlinga Nii Endi Kannantu Yelthu Ricci Bangari Kannantu Bhagyamiche Unde Makkodukalu Uttuttu Ranga Galigi Nimbuki Neeretti Natla Galigi Settaki Pogetti Natla Galigi Kavare Palli Kudisagi Natla Galigi Marulu Davuru Jattisi Natla Galigi నిండి నిశలకి తూబెత్తినట్లు కలిగి కొండైన వారికి పక్షి వాలినట్లు కలిగి ఒక్కింటికి 1000 ఇండ్లు కలిగి 1100 ఏళ్ళు సంతానము కలిగి రామనగర్ పాలు పొంగినట్లు పొంగనప్ప కొండాపురు మాబోబుళి నరసింహ 5 కళ్ళు శివశిత్రులింగ నీ ఎండి కన్నంత ఎల్తరిచ్చి బంగారి కన్నంత భాగ్యమిచ్చే ఉండే మక్కొడకలు ఉత్తు రంగ కలిగి నింబుకి నీరెత్తినట్లు కలిగి చెట్టుకి పోగెత్తినట్లు కలిగే అవరే బళ్ళె కుడిసాగినట్లు కలిగి మరులు దావురు జడిసినట్లు కలిగే నిండిన చెరువుకి తూబెత్తినట్లు కలిగి పండైన మానికి పక్షి వాలినట్లు కలిగే ఒక్కింటికి 1000 ఇండ్లు కలిగి 1100 ఏళ్ళు సంతానము కలిగి రామనగర్ పాలు పొంగినట్లు పొంగనప్ప కొండాపురు మాబోబుళి నరసింహ 5 కళ్ళు శివశిత్రులింగ నీ ఎండి కన్నంత ఎల్తరిచ్చి బంగారి కన్నంత భాగ్యమిచ్చే ఉండే మక్కొడతలు ఉత్తురం కలిగి నింపుకి నీరెత్తినట్లు కలిగే ఇగో నేనేమంట హరికిస్తో ఏమంట మేలు కోరుదో పచ్చి కళ్యాణం నిచ్చుతోణం కలిగి ఒక్కింటికి 1000 ఇండ్లు కలిగి 1100 ఏళ్ళు సంతానము కలిగి రామనగర్ పాలు పొంగినట్లు పొంగినప్ప కొండాపురు మాబోబుళి నరసింహ 5 కళ్ళు శివశిత్రులింగ నీ ఎండి కన్నంత ఎల్తరిచ్చి బంగారి కన్నంత భాగ్యమిచ్చే ఉండే మక్కొడకలు ఉత్తురం కలిగి నింపుకి నీరెత్తినట్లు కలిగే ఇగో నాకు ఒక ఆవిచ్చిన మోక్షమందో గాటిడావులు కలిగి గూటిడెద్దులు కలిగి మందుకి మంద మారు మంద కలగని బేతూరు సిరియాలప్పని కంపలమో సిరియార్తో వచ్చినట్లు రాని మాధురాయన కంపలం మరిలినట్లు మరలే గబ్బు పీడం మాయం పొప్పిసగంట గలంత వారగలగని రా కొండాపురు మాబోబుళి నరసింహ 5 కళ్ళు శివశిత్రులింగ నీ ఎండి కన్నంత ఎల్తరిచ్చి బంగారి కన్నంత భాగ్యమిచ్చి ఉండే మక్కొడతలు
What we would like to do, because it's not so much time, we'll start with like maybe you guys didn't understand, maybe you understood a little bit of Kannada, second one was in Telugu. So if you ask questions, then Gopi and all of us, whatever, but Gopi will mainly try to explain and clarify anything that he can, right? So Arun.
How do they pass on this knowledge from one generation to the other? Like when they get old, how does it remain?
Normally, one of the children who is not educated takes up this profession because most other children will take up other jobs. So that person goes along with the father or whoever is carrying. It is through long years of apprenticeship he learned, because remembering their villages, the families, and all that, it takes time. And also understanding a very complex system. Because, for example, this family is, we have 9 villages in Chalukere Taluka, and in these 9 villages, we have about 500 such families who are covering about 3.2 lakh population, and also they are covering all the castes and sub-castes of that area. And this family is covering Kadu Golla community. In that Kadu Golla, there is one Maru Golla and one Chitta Golla. And this family only covers that Maru Golla families kind of a thing. So normally, it is through going through along with them they learn.
The quick answer is they're also ordained. So it goes through their children and all that if they're ready. Right?
Are they like the Mangniar communities of Rajasthan where they go door-to-door actually telling the genealogy and the history of the families. So that's, and what are their children now doing? Ask these two people. I want to know.
ಇವರು ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ.
ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ, ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದಾರಮ್ಮ, ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಎಲ್ಲ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಕಸು ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಬರ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಈ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿಗೆ ಸೇರಿ 500-600 ಕೂಲಿ ಅಂತ ಕೂಲಿ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ವರ್ಷಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಸಾರಿ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಊರಿಗೆ. ಅಲ್ಲೇ ತನಕ ನಾವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಕಸಿಪಿನಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಮುದುಕರು ಆಗಿ ಹಿಂಗಂದ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅತ್ತನ ಇಸ್ಕೊಂಡು
ಮುಂದಿನ ಪೀಳಿಗೆಗೆ ಯಾರು ಮಾಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಇದನ್ನು.
ಆ ಗೌರವ ಮನೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು. ಆ ಈ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಬರೋ ತನಕ ಆ ಗೌರವ ಮನೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಇಸ್ಕೊಬಂದು ಕಾಳು ಕಡಿ ಕುರಿ ಮರಿ ದುಡ್ಡು ದುಗ್ಗಾಣಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಕಳಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಅವ್ನ ಜೀವನ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರೊಳಗೆ ಇವ್ರ ಹಬ್ಬದಾಗ ಉಣ್ಣೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇರ್ತೀವಿ. ನಮಗೆ ಹೊಲಗಳಿಲ್ಲ, ಮನೆಗಳಿಲ್ಲ, ನಾವು ಅಲೆಮಾರಿ ಜಾತಿ. ನಾವೇನು ಈ ಗೌಡ್ರಿಗೆ ಹೇಳೋದು, ನಮಗೆ ಚಾವಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಒಂದು ಮಠ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಯಾವುದಿಲ್ಲ. 48 ಕುಲದ ಗೌಡ್ರ ಜಾತಿ ಗೋತ್ರಗಳು ಅವ್ರ ದೇವರು ದಿಂಡ್ರುಗಳು ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಕಾಲ ಕಳೀತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಅಲೆಮಾರಿ ಜನ ಹೇಳುವ ಎಳುವ.
I'm the guy who answers. Tell her for your asking questions.
And he said very interesting thing like, so all his children are going to Bangalore to make for coolie jobs 500-600 rupees because also their patrons, their caste patrons, they used to actually support their living. Like whenever they go, they used to give them, if they are rich, either cow or goat or sheep or grains, or if nothing then just like, you know, they give this palm leaf and that's even so much. So if they are also changing their patronizing, their kids are going to cities, they are also moving away, so their patrons are like kind of ending.
Yeah, but still there are higher than people practicing this. Out of 600 families, one person each family takes over. Maybe it's brother, son, or somebody who is not literate and cannot get employed outside, who doesn't want to go. Those people are continuing this.
So like somebody said, like there were 25 families, now they are reduced to 4. So 4 are serving more people, and this is the fringe of what you see, right? So that's one way they continue. But the crucial thing, Anita, is it would be amazing that this skill is of some use for us, right? This is what we're doing, right? Instead of going through and saying, Arun, can you do the storytelling? Why don't you do a narrative? Come sing. That's like a lot more training than getting them to, right? So, yeah.
So, do they earn living out of it?
Let me explain you the economy, how they survive and sustain, because they were the old census collection part of the village. They were the ones who were collecting all the data and things like that. So there is a very interesting system which the villagers have evolved that revolves around Gudikattu, that is the temple through which. In this Gudikattu, they have this major role to play in terms of keeping documents. Actually, there are 7 other people. Like the Gudi Gowda is there. There is another person, Yajmana. Then you also have Kilari, because most temples will have cows. So the kind of cows, they are the ones who were keeping the genealogy of the cows also. Like, for example, we have divine herds in that area, about 3,000-4,000 cows in that area. And those 3,000-4,000 cows, they don't take milk, it is considered divine, and it is left for the calves. They don't even use the manure in the agriculture fields, kind of a thing. So they don't sell, they don't do anything. But still imagine managing 2,000-3,000 cows in that kind of a landscape is a nightmare. Our government and other departments who have set up farms have closed them and are not able to run that. But the villagers give 2 cows extra every year, as this one, and then also pay these people the grains and whatever their requirements are, as and when they ask for. For example, there's a wedding, they need big money, people donate and give them.
I want to add another interesting thing when I was interviewing them. So there's also this, every year all these temples will have a jatre. There is a festival of few days that will go on, and all the community will pool in the resources. They'll pool in monies and donations from the community people. And at that time, all these people of the who were helping in running this socio-economic political organization, Helavas or Kolkar or the Messenger, all of these people will get a good enough remuneration from the donations they got from the community also, like annual remuneration. Apart from that, they also go to the houses, get all these grains and other things.
So does yes. government acknowledge them?
I think only recently they have been recognized, otherwise they were never ever came into the SCST kind of a list as such. Now they have recognized that, and also they have a very important role to play, because I don't know if you see the wild country Osho's film, how all these temples, Shabarimalai, all these things are coming up. These are the people who are resolving all the asset conflicts, management issues and things like that. So their evidence is very recognized by the courts and laws in resolving many disputes within the family, in the community temples and things like that. So that way we'll have a story, he'll tell you about how he resolved one conflict in the village.
There are about 70,000 of these people, but only like 70 people call themselves Helavaru because there's no recognition.
Okay. Thank you for sharing this very unique experience. This makes it one of the more memorable parts of the Southeast Asia conferences I've attended. My question is, what is the personal motivation or what drives them to continue this tradition?
You know Facebook?
I don't use Facebook.
All these kinds of traditions like sheep herding and doing this, it is they think the God, it is a divine assignment which is got from them. You know, and that is the assignment what they have got, gives them a very sustainable kind of livelihood in terms of whatever work we are doing. You know, we get food security, we get remuneration, and also man samman for our work. So these people have a very high man samman in the villages and communities. So even, for example, many of them belong to scheduled caste, but higher caste people wash their feet, don't discriminate them, and then are revered and respected. For example, their opinions, like they are like legal advisors in terms of resolving many conflicts about properties, assets and all in the village.
So, excuse me, sir. This is actually the decentralized distributed Facebook. I'm not kidding, okay?
My question is that we had collected a lot of data about all our families and all the data about our ancestors. Even I don't know the name of my great-grandfather. So they are helping us a lot. They have huge data, and they are using this paper and writing it and passing it to the next generations. And they are about to end their generations. I mean, Helavas are going to be end. So why don't they give us the data and we digitalize the data? I mean,
it's actually very good material for AI.
Yes. So that is what I am asking.
Yeah, so maybe that should be one of our collective projects, right? We are going to put everything in the open. This already I passed the short link, but it will keep on growing as an archive, right? from our side.
I just want to continue on that. I mean, this is an excellent way of how I understand community radio and how archiving has already been done in the form of audio form. And I was thinking, if I have to push this further, that I think the professor mentioned that how we know about Sita, Ramayana, and it's because I'm a Christian, but in spite of that, I know Hanuman Chalisa because I've been hearing it. People recite the same tone. So when both of them were performing, I heard there was a tone, there was some kind of music, I didn't understand a word. So I was thinking if the next generation, because it's they're working through memory, and I have done that as a child when I was learning multiplication. I knew nothing, but I was repeating the same thing again. That's exactly how I learned. So memory point of view, I never wrote anything. So I was also thinking if the next generation, because like he said, I don't know anything about my great-grandfathers, but if my mother had forced me to do the same thing, just because it's also my family genealogy and it's data that matters, if and this kind of, it runs in our families. This oral tradition was part of at least my growing up, I don't know about today, but I think so there is a way of preserving it. It's just that we have to unlearn what we have and learn from, ask them the methodology, how they are doing it.
Yeah, I think we can imagine there would be a son who would perform all this, but not the one who does Kuli, but Google AI, virtual 3D. Sorry.
Hi. I had a similar experience as well. Some years ago, actually, I consulted with one of the elders in my dad's village, and he was able to give me a genealogy of nearly 9 generations. He was able to tell like which village we were, etc. So my dad actually went behind all these villages. So also they gave us the 1,000-year lineage, but I somewhat it was up. But what I'll say about this is that the pain is that the elder is dead actually, and we didn't record. That history has been lost right now, except now I know about my family, but I do not know how much else he has stored. So I think the recording has to be done in some way. I mean, at least even if it is not AI or something like that, at least an audio recording or something like that would be even good. That is one way to start. The other one is a question actually. Since these are pastoral communities, do they have any kind of land rights related to the grazing area? That is one.
They are not pastoral. Pastoral are another community, but
they are not. Okay. Thanks.
Tell about the pastoral communities, like one of their...
Okay. They don't have any land rights or anything like that.
Yeah, but the interesting thing is, because of Gopi, when we were traveling, he said, those are the Helavaru. I was like, what? And I went there and I was fascinated. That's how it started, right? But just to get to the point, now that you all know, you know what to do. Just be fascinated, rest will work, right?
Hi, I have one.
We have room for only 2 questions, one there right. And one there.
So the daily lifestyle of the storytellers and how they resolve conflict as well, I wanted to understand, is it like a daily job where they're actively going out every day? And if yes, then, I mean, how far do they go out each day?
So there are 2 helavas. One is the Yattina Helava and the other is Ganta Helava, and Gopi is
going to say. For example, Hanuman Tappa, he has another caste called Upparus, Uppar caste. Where he belongs. He goes up to Davangere, Chitradurga, and faraway places. So their catchment area is something like 300 miles kind of a thing. Okay.
And one day, how far would they go?
What they will do is they will go to one gudikatte, sit there, and surrounding villages. For example, he will go to Davangere. There are 10 villages of Upparu communities there. So he'll one day, every day, he'll go one village to one village and then document and keep all the documentation, things like that. So it's the way they keep their documentation system is very interesting. Like the main item they collect is caste, gotra, kattebade, kuladevaru, gudikattu, vamshavruksha, occupation, family migration and all this data.
Dinesh, just one comment from my friend that the questions that we've asked, we'd like if we can convey that, especially the idea about AI and the tech part, that would be really interesting if it can be conveyed to them.
Yes. All right.
Wait. This is only one question, but I think Dinesh will be here to talk. It's fine. Yeah. Because there's so many questions, I agree.
Hi, my name is Mangal, and I would want to start with before a question. I want to have an expression here, an honest and blunt, where I felt a bit sad about when we see a kind of a tradition getting died. We get greedy about how do we get this? How do I get the data to do something? And we never ask a question: what the mapping community has to do to keep them sustained and help them to grow. So I think I would, with that, this is an open question for all of us. Instead of getting into an AI and all that, they have something and which is unique for India. And how do we preserve it? How do we preserve it getting into hand of global giants? And how do we help them to assist? So now I'm coming to a question. How do you think the open source mapping community can help them sustain and give them the livelihood, and when their generation is dying, to so that they can continue?
Yeah,
thank you. First of all, thank you. You stole the content out of my slides.
I just want to add a comment. You see, this community has got a very intelligent system on through which they are working. Okay, let us understand that system first, then think about artificial intelligence. Because we are assuming that we need AI, but I think this kind of a very intelligent system, which is delivering, sustaining, with community support, with a very little of, you know, energy, resource, and things like that, we need to understand this complex intelligent system. I think that will give us a lot of insights how to run the world.
I don't know how much time Sajjad can. I have to target you. Some excuse. He just said, you know, it's on the fringe. But the whole idea of land and fringe is that to make us fearful, right? Sorry. Go on, ask a couple of more questions and then we'll wrap it up, if you have, otherwise. Yeah.
To archive all the genealogies, so probably they'll get it. They are a tough competition to genie.com, I would say.
Yeah, that's a very Western, but I know what you're talking about, yeah. One thing very subtle but most significant thing is it's not denotational, it's connotational, right? So keep that in mind when we compare it to portals that record just one data point, right?
Yes, so just one question.
Haley, madam.
So when it passes on from one generation to another, does it become Chinese whispers by any chance ever?
So I tried to explain the blockchain methodology. So you have to understand Merkle chains, right? but the point is, there is duplication in the recording, and most of the narratives are based on records, right? And the problem with Chinese whisper is it doesn't ask for you to accept it and like it. It just goes on. This is about liking, right? You reassert it. It's a big, big difference. Once you reassert and reassert and reassert, every small thing will get like thrown off. But there might be little Chinese whispers, intentional, like Facebook does. It used to allow you only to like, right? No other thing, right? They're afraid that if you don't like, Facebook will fall off. Same thing here, their income comes from praising. Hoguludu is another word, right? Our hoguludu. So there's a phase that comes after they tell the genealogy story. If you have time, you can sit with him separately. Once you give, here's my little pitch. If you want to contribute, please do. If you're foreigners, I would recommend you to give him something from your denomination so he can go home and talk about where he was. But anyway, so once you give him a little thing, he will start praising, right? So it's this whole chain and the copying, and when it's distributed and decentralized, how the duplication happens, where it's the reaffirmation, right? It's almost like blockchain. That's where the trust comes. So, yeah.
Hi. Mr. Gopi here mentioned that even in the court of law, they are taken as proof, and continuing to his point, may I ask the Helavas directly as to how can an NGO or we get the government to help them grow their community, either to fund them so that their children do not discontinue or continue it, or somebody else joins them and learn this culture?
Yeah, I think it'd be good to talk to them in person. I don't know what they're prepared to answer here, but I think that engagement is essential for them. That's what I would say. But we all have our own something to say to what you said, but I think we should wrap up unless Sajjad allows one more question.
I'm going to snatch the mic. Thank you so much, Dinesh. This has been fantastic. So we have to hurry outside the room because there's something else that's going to happen here in a few minutes. But we're not done yet. We have another hour of Birds of a Feather sessions. I think there are 5 sessions happening. And they're all between N001, Central Pergola, or Glassroom, or an outdoor space. They're all on the whiteboard. And after that, we go to hang out at Yellow Submarine. Okay, I'll see you guys all in some time.